In this episode, we are going to see the elements of roads, such as how the number of lanes are calculated and the minimum lane width required, the details of central median, the benefits of service roads, the key role of T-junctions, and the importance of roundabouts. So, please watch carefully till the end. Welcome to Civil Guru. These videos made in different languages, like English, Hindi, Tamil, and also in Arabic now. Please choose your desired language from our playlist. If you like this video, please like and subscribe now, and share it with your friends. Thank you. Here, we will discuss about the highways. On highways, minimum of 2 lanes are used, one for to and one for fro. The lanes are separated by centerline markings. The width of the road and the number of lanes shall be designed to accommodate the type and volume of traffic, the design speed of vehicles, and the vehicles passing at the slower speed. Nowadays, the traffic density, vehicle speed, and the truck widths have increased. To accommodate this, the 2-lane highway have also increased the width from 5 meters to the current recommended width of 7.2 meters. The minimum carriage width requires is 3.35 meters. However, the safe and comfortable lane width is 3.50 meters. The total number of lanes are calculated based on the number of vehicles passing in 1 hour. And also, it is calculated based on type of vehicles, such as commercial vehicles, heavy vehicles, and light vehicles, etc. Based on the traffic, there are 6-lane and also the 8-laning roads are there. However, 4-laning roads are most commonly used in the world. In 4-laning, one lane is for heavy or slower vehicle movements, and another lane is for light or faster vehicles. Similarly, the other 2 lanes are kept for opposite direction traffic. If the number of vehicle passing in faster lane is more than 200 numbers per hour, then one more lane shall be considered for free flow of traffic. In general, for every 200 numbers of vehicle, one lane shall be considered. Next is the central median or central verge. When the number of laning is increased from 2-laning to 4-laning or above, then the central median is used to separate the lanes passing in opposite direction to avoid any accidents. The width of these median is varies from 1.2 meters to 20 meters and above. Where the median is narrow, the raised concrete curbs are provided. And where the greater widths are available, there, the normal size concrete curbs may, or may not, be used. In rural area, the wide division alone serves the purpose, and no raised barrier is employed. Median is an important component of roads. Now, let us know about the service roads. Service roads, or frontage roads, run parallel to the main road and allow local traffic to gain access to the property. Where major roads are bordered by commercial or residential development, the service roads are a safe way to allow vehicles to access these properties with little disruption to other traffic. Crashes can occur where a commercial development is fronted by parking spaces with uncontrolled access to the carriageway. The service roads can be used to bring traffic to a single and safe T-junction at the main road. The benefits of service roads. 1. Crash reductions, including parking and pedestrian crashes. 2. Can reduce the number of conflict points, intersections, along a route. 3. Can be used by local traffic and vulnerable road users as an alternative to the, often higher speeds and higher volume, main road. 4. Safer loading, unloading of commercial vehicles. But there are some implementation issues. 1. Service roads require large amounts of space. Where space is limited, a service road may fit behind the properties. 2. Parking and other potential visual obstructions should be carefully controlled where service lanes rejoin the main road. The next chapter is T-junctions and link roads. Unexpectedly, tight horizontal bends can lead to crashes when drivers try to negotiate them at high speed. On narrow roads, vehicles may cross into the path of an approaching vehicle on tight bends, or they may travel onto shoulders and pedestrian areas. there are several ways in which the horizontal alignment of a road may be modified to improve safety. These include increasing the curve radius, providing transition curves to facilitate the gradual transition of driver steering from straight sections of road to bends, removing compound curves or improving super elevations. The horizontal alignment of intersection approaches may be realigned to improve sight distance or to reduce approach speeds and reinforce priority at the intersection. For example, at a T-junction, where the major roads are connected with highways, there, a well-developed T-junctions are adopted by providing small islands to separate the lanes to control the traffic. Whereas, when village roads are connected, there, a simple link roads are provided without any islands. The benefits of T-junction: 1. Reduces the risk of head-on crashes. 2. Reduces the risk of run-off road crashes. 3. Better traffic flow. But the implementation issues are: the horizontal realignments often includes the lane widening, shoulder improvement, and delineation treatments, which requires considerable design and construction efforts, and also requires the purchase of land. Now, we will see about roundabouts. A roundabout is a one-way roadway around a circular central island. Entry to roundabouts is controlled by give-way markings and signs. Vehicles already on the roundabout have right-of-way. Roundabouts cause little delay in low to medium traffic flows and require less maintenance than signalized intersections. Design is crucial of roundabout, which helps to improve the safety. The curves on the approaches require all vehicles to slow down before entering. The center island ensures that traffic moves in one-way direction and slow speeds are maintained. The drivers approaching a roundabout need to slow and give way to vehicles already in the roundabout and be prepared to stop. The benefits of roundabout: 1. Minimal delays at lower traffic volumes. 2. Little maintenance required. 3. Crash severity is usually lower than at cross intersections. The implementation issues are: 1. Solid structures should not be located on the central island. 2. Roundabouts can be difficult for large vehicles to use, particularly heavy trailers and buses. 3. Designers should be conscious to facilitate, to help pedestrians, for cyclists, and other slow vehicles, such as animal-drawn vehicles. Before ending this session, let us have a look at what we have learned today. The minimum safe width of a lane is 3.5 meters. For two-laning, a minimum of 7.2 meters width is required. For every 200 vehicles per hour, one separate lane shall be provided. The central median is used to separate the lanes. Where the median width is narrow, there, minimum 1.20 meters height concrete curbs shall be used. The service roads are used to access to the residential area for local traffic. Where major roads are connecting with highway, there, the T-junctions are developed for clear vision and smooth access to the major roads. When more than one major road is connecting at the same point, there, roundabouts are introduced to control the traffic. If you like this video, please subscribe now. Also, share with your friends. Thank you.